The last time I shared some juicy SEO experiments with you was from the roof of an amphitheater in Poland. And now I'm going to share some more juicy SEO experiments with you, this time from the top floor of a brownstone in Brooklyn. The first one of these experiments is super actionable white hat SEO advice. Super actionable, really easy, super easy to understand, concrete conclusion. And then the second one is black hat. The second one is a lot more against the rules, and it's risky. That's what the second one is. And I'm actually reversing these in the order that they appear. I'm sharing the super actionable, easy one, which is white hat, which is not against the rules. I'm sharing that first. And then the second riskier, more against the rules one, I'm sharing that second. This, of course, comes from the 21 SEO experiments that will change the way you think about SEO forever article, which I've shared on this show before. I've shared a bunch of experiments now. This article is from SEOSherpa.com. If you want to go to it, it's SEOSherpa.com/SEO-experiments. So I'm going to share experiment number 9 first, and then experiment number 8. Experiment number 9 is link to other websites to lift your ranking. This is experiment number 9, and this is what it says. Outbound links dilute your site's authority. Outbound links just means linking to another site from your website. Outbound links dilute your site's authority. That has been the generally conceived notion in the world of SEO for some time. And this, despite Google saying that linking to related sources is a good practice. So why are SEOs so against outbound links? The idea is that outbound links lose you page rank. The more outbound links, the more page rank you give away. And since PageRank means losing authority, the outcome of linking out is lower rankings, right? Well, let's find out. So PageRank, you get more PageRank by having backlinks, by having sites link to your site. You want to have as many authoritative sites as you can linking to your website, and that is how you build PageRank. It's called link building. And the value of a link, put in the most easy way to understand, is how authoritative that link is. More authoritative links carry more value, and links get authority by the websites that link to them. And that is basically how links within Google works and how authority, domain authority within Google works. And so the conventional wisdom was that when you link out to other sites from your site, you are giving away PageRank. You are giving away your authority. At least that's what SEOs think, and that is what this experiment is testing. So this is what it says. The team at Reboot put this notion to the test in their outgoing links experiment. For the experiment, Reboot set up 10 websites, all with similar domain formats and structure. Each website contained a unique 300-word article, which was optimized for a made-up word, philandocystic. That's the made-up word. Prior to the test, the word philandocystic showed zero results in Google. I actually want to Google this myself right now and see what happens. Philandocystic. Oh, it's all here from the study. That's so funny. In order to test the effect of outbound links, 3 full follow links were added to 5 of the 10 domains. In SEO, there are follow links and no follow links. Follow links pass on page rank. No follow links supposedly don't, but then there's a further study in here that show that actually no follow links also help. But follow links are traditionally the most valuable. So 3 full follow links were added to 5 of the 10 domains. This means these follow links were supposedly giving away PageRank. The links pointed to highly trusted websites. Oxford University, which has a domain authority of 92 out of 100, that's super high. Genome Research Institute, domain authority of 85 out of 100, also super high. Cambridge University, domain authority of 93 out of 100. Once all the test websites were indexed by Google, the rankings were recorded. Here's the results. And then I'm just gonna show this image, but we see it's clear as night and day. Every single website with outbound links outranked those without. So all of the websites that linked out to other sites, they did better than the sites that did not link out to other sites. And this SEO experiments article says, this means your action step is simple. Each time you post an article to your site, make sure it includes a handful of links to relevant and trustworthy resources. As Reboot's experiment provided, it will serve your readers and your rankings. So that's experiment number 9, link to other websites to lift your rankings. Really easy to understand, really concrete. Just link out. and it makes your pages do better with SEO. Okay, now here is the more controversial one. Like I said, I'm going to give a warning. This one might go a bit against the rules. So you don't have to try this one, but if you're curious in something a bit darker shade, this is it. And it is called Exact Match Anchor Text Links Beat Non-Anchor Match Links. So I'm going to explain. Don't worry if you don't get it. If you've read a thing or two about SEO, you'll have learned that exact match anchor text is bad. Too many links saying the same thing are unnatural and could land you with a penalty. So an example of exact match anchor text would be if you are a Google AdWords management agency and you have a link that goes to your website, and then instead of like the link saying click here or the name of your agency, it says the link actually just says Google AdWords management agency. That is exact match anchor text. Your keyword is Google AdWords management agency and the link uses the keyword exactly. That's exact match anchor text. And so the wisdom is that too many links saying the same thing are unnatural. And if you have an unnatural link profile, Google will sense something spammy is up and then your site will do worse. You might get hit with a penalty or your pages just will not rank well. So that is the belief. And that is what this experiment is testing. Ever since Google Penguin was released to put a stop to manipulative link building, the advice from experts has been to keep anchor text ratios low. In simple terms, that means you want a mix of links to your site so that no one keyword-rich anchor text makes up more than a small percentage of the total. Raw links like yourdomain.com, as well as generic links like your brand name, click here, and visit this website are all good. More than a small percentage of keyword-rich links is bad. So it's saying more than a small percentage of exact match anchor text links is bad. You only want that for a small percentage. And that is the belief. The article continues, a varied and natural link profile will look something like mine. And then this article shares the website's link profile. So we can see the majority of links. And if you're watching on YouTube, you'll be able to see the pie chart for a normal link profile. As you can see, the majority of links are for my brand name, which is SEO Sherpa. The rest are mostly other anchor text. With that in mind, what happens when you point 20 links to a website all with the same keyword-rich anchor text? So that is the experiment. And the result? Your rankings skyrocket. That's what. In a series of three experiments, Rand Fishkin tested pointing 20 generic anchor links to a web page versus 20 exact match anchor text links. Rand Fishkin, if you don't know, he's the guy who just did the enormous Google leak. He is responsible for making that super public. Google's biggest leak of all time. He is responsible for making that super public. And he did that because he did all of these SEO experiments and he was super belittled by representatives at Google. And he felt like he had a bone to pick. And I've shared this so many times on the podcast before, what happened with the Google leak. But back to this article. So Rand Fishkin is at it again with some awesome experiments and he wants to test this. In a series of three experiments, Rand Fishkin tested pointing 20 generic anchor links to a page versus 20 exact match anchor text links. In each case, the exact match anchor text increased the ranking of the target pages significantly. So in every case, the ranking of the target pages increased, and in 2 out of 3 tests, the exact match anchor text websites catapulted the generic anchor text websites in the results. Here's the before rankings from test 2 in Rand's series. So there's result A and result B. Result A has 20 links from the same pages and domains with exact match anchor text. And then result B uses the same amount, but the links did not contain the query. The query is the keyword. So result A uses links with the keyword that's exact match. Result B does not. And then after 16 days, all of the links had been indexed by Google, and A, with all the exact match, moved up 19 positions to number 1, and B moved up 5 positions to number 9. Wow. So that is pretty darn conclusive. Exact match anchor text is considerably more powerful than non-anchor match links and surprisingly powerful overall. It's crazy. 20 exact match links. Because really the wisdom is, and I've seen it before, where people have purchased links, which goes against Google's terms of service, and all they did was purchase exact match links. And it actually hurt their rankings. I've seen that personally from people, but it could have been in those instances that they purchased bad links. That is possible as well. But so Rand's experiment, pointing 20 exact match links for the keyword, got this page from position 20 to number 1. And that is crazy. It goes against all of the wisdom, but it's also more risky. Such a wild study. Both these studies are great. So I hope you enjoyed these. Again, this is from SEOSherpa.com/SEO-experiments. I'm always reading these on the show. I love these. This was one of those things. This article originally came out in 2016. It's been updated since. At least once a year, this article is updated. This article, when it came out, I have these vivid memories just sitting on my couch late in the evening in my apartment in Williamsburg in Brooklyn, in a different place than I am now. And just sitting on that couch and just reading these, so engaged because I'm learning how Google really works, not what Google representatives say should happen and what should be done, but what actually happens when these different tests are performed. And if you want to learn about how Google really works, you need to see the results of different tests. And if you read all 21 of these, you'll have a great idea for what is important to Google and what is not. And I've read all of these multiple times. And I think it's one of the many reasons why I'm as good at SEO as I am, is because I look at the actual results, what is performed and the actual results of what is performed. And this article, it contains so much value in it. And I would totally recommend this article. So this, wow, oh my gosh, this is episode 350 of The Edwards Show. 350 consecutive days in a row doing this podcast. This is my daily digital marketing podcast. Can't believe 350 days in a row. Wow. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for being here with me. I hope you enjoy these. I will talk to you again tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be a big day, and I will talk to you again. You'll hear why tomorrow. I will talk to you again tomorrow. Bye now.